I'm very concerned. Why, I hear you say in a big, loud voice. I'll tell you why. Because I've been rehearsing all day to get this show right. Knock it off. Shut up. And it's not going to work. No, some of the... I was getting to know the studio audience before the show. And when I say getting to know, I mean, you know, helping them. Helping them relax using my special massage technique. Well, anyway...
In your pants.
No, not in my pants. That's what happened. Jeff started going crazy and saying, in my pants all the time. In my pants.
In your pants.
In my pants.
In your pants. In your pants.
Now, actually, I've got some bad news for Jeff and for lots of people who like him. Well, the people who like him. I heard today from the Union of Sidekicks of America, and they're a little upset. A, because they are not real, I've just made them up. And B, did you just sneeze right in the middle of my... That's right. We'll embarrass you if you sneeze here. Don't you come to this show and sneeze. Man, that's close, man. You've got that camera very close to that young lady. That would be like if I was like this. She is better looking than me. Yeah, you're all right, yeah. Mind you, being better looking than me is like being the tallest midget. You know what I mean? It's like... No, you are. You're lovely. I didn't mean that at all. Are you a little person? Could you stand up, please? Just stand up for a minute, just to prove it. Wow, look at that. Look how tall you are. Why are you so nervous about being seen? Are you here with someone you shouldn't be with? We can't hear you. It's almost like you're part of... Yeah, well, go on, give her a microphone now. Go on. What are you pointing at? Are you all right? Speak into that microphone there. Have you got terrible indigestion? Are you all right? I'm worried about you.
I'm fine.
All right. Well, you know you're sitting in lesbian row. I thought maybe it was... No. You were trying to... Are you all right?
I'm fine.
Right, well, good. Tonight's show will be the usual... Well, what's your name?
Desi?
You got some splaining to do. We'll take a break. We'll be back with the show.
The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Applebee's. See what's new on Applebee's 2 for 20 menu. Classics you love and new flavors you'll crave.
Okay, you can always sleep through work tomorrow, okay? Hey!
Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
If it were natural and heartfelt. Oh, I'm so excited. What a wonderful studio audience we have this evening.
I'm saying the opposite of what's true for comedic effect.
I'm only kidding. It's a fantastic audience. I'm very excited because it's Friday, everybody, which means it's a great day for America. Yes, it is. And today is a great day because I've just heard about this. There's a man in Texas, which is part of America. A man in Texas has created, and this is true, deep-fried beer. See, back in my younger days, we had a word for men like this. We called them genius. Finally, deep-fried beer. Deep-fried beer. And here's me stuck in this tofu-loving, sober, monogamous hell. Why was I born in the wrong time? Deep-fried beer. Curse you, science. 18 and a half years too late. Couple of big movies opening today I'm very excited about. There's a new movie from M. Night Shyamalan. You know the M. Night Shyamalan... that made the movie about the lady in the water. All the whispery movies. The whispery movies. What? Whispery movies. He's got a new movie out called Devil. It's about a bunch of people who's stuck in an elevator. An elevator made of murder. He didn't direct the movie, so you'll probably be able to hear everyone in it. Because if he directed me, this is where you have to get off. Did you say turn your head and cough? Anyway, you know what bothers me about the movie is not that, it's the fact that the movie's called Devil, and it's about an elevator. Now, I'm not a genius, but isn't this a golden opportunity to name a movie Hellevator? Why do I have to do all the work? Why do I, Jeff?
Love it.
Thank you. Hellevator. All right, it's not deep-fried beer, but it's good. Anyway, the movie that really intrigues me this weekend, though, is the other one, Easy A. That's one of those titles make me wish I was a film reviewer. You could put up the one-liner for the review. Easy A gets an A. All right, that's not that clever, but Hellevator is clever. Anyway, Easy A is a comedy about a high school girl that gets branded Easy by her classmates. It's based on Nathaniel Hawthorne's 1850 novel, The Scarlet Letter, because nothing says box office magic like a 160-year-old novel by an angry New England moralist. That's what the kids love. Well, if you watch the commercials for the movie, you won't see anything about it based, about it being based on a masterwork of American literature. The kids don't want to learn anything in movies, except maybe that vampires have feelings too. But, I mean, I don't know how long this is gonna go on. When will it end? Yeah. I mean, I don't want to get on your case, young folks of America, but couldn't we have a bit of rebellion or something? Please. Anyway, when they update the old movies, old movies like this for the old books into movies, you know what I mean? Old things, stories. What I mean is, look, it was set in 1850 and now, you know, it was written in 1850, it's set now, so they have to update it, they have to account for technology. Huh, look, it doesn't have the same... It's like when, if they update Romeo and Juliet, Romeo has to tweet his love to Juliet. OMG, parents think you're a whore, LMAO. That's what I mean. Now, I know...
Thank you.
I know what you're thinking. Why do the studios make movies out of the old books, Craig? I hear you say quietly. I think I can hear you say it. It's like an M. Night Shyamalan movie. Well, I'll tell you why. Come here, I'll tell you the secret why everybody, they do that. Because everyone in Hollywood is gay.
No kidding.
No, that's the wrong secret. No, the secret is that the old novels like The Scarlet Letter, they're in public domain. There's no copyright. They're free. They can use the story free. It's like they're as free as the CDs at Starbucks. They're free, aren't they? Come on, who wants to spend real money on Bobby McFerrin? I don't mean the actual CDs. I mean actually Bobby McFerrin, who now works in Starbucks. Don't worry. Have a latte. Anyway, for those of you who don't know, perhaps you skipped high school English too. The Scarlet Letter is a book. It's a book, became a movie. It's about a woman who commits adultery and she's forced to wear a scarlet letter near her shoulder, like the L used to wear in Laverne and Shirley, right? Except that Laverne was more evil and the L stood for lesbian. But... everyone in Hollywood is gay. Anyway, the Scarlet Letter was an A. It stood for adultery, you see? But I also like to think it stood for, ah, yeah. Do that again, Jeff. Yeah, Jeff likes it too, apparently.
Love it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, well, because I think Nathaniel Hawthorne was a bit sexy. He also wrote a short story called The Bosom Serpent. Really, in 1843, he wrote a story called The Bosom Serpent. I actually have performed a bosom serpent once or twice. Can he mean we're at? Yes, I do mean that. Can I say that on TV? Yes, I can. Because everything is implied. The bosom serpent is what you think it is.
In your pants.
In my pants?
In your pants.
In my pants?
In your pants.
In my pants?
In your pants. In your pants. Remind you of anyone?
All right. I give in. We have to take a break. When we come back, no innuendo or the usual crap. All right. Is it Jeffrey Peterson?
Tweets and emails are up next.
Euro trashes and Euro litter. Get on the dance floor and shake your Twitter. Bum, 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 bum. Check the tweets.
Plus, emails.
Plus the email. Here's an email. This is from Mary in Fort Collins in Colorado. She says, "Hi, Craig. I keep seeing commercials on TV about how much work BP is going to help with the Gulf Coast. Or work BP is doing to help with the Gulf Coast. What do you think? I don't know. Have you seen these commercials on CBS? Are they on CBS? Oh, well, then I expect they are going to help. Uh, That's like, oh, look, I took a dump in your carpet, but don't worry, I'm going to clean it up. I'm an eye gray. It would be better if you just didn't dump on the carpet at all.
CBS cares.
All right, this is from Sue in Norwalk in Ohio. Sue says, Sue's an owl, which is amazing when you think about it. That there's a new movie coming out that's all about owls. What's it called? Owl Parade or something? Land of the Owls, Legend of the Owls, Hootie and the Blowfish. You know what was it? Legend of the Guardians. About owls that guard things using their straight... Do you know that owls, their eyes can't move? Their heads can swivel around a lot, but their eyes stay fixed in place the whole time. Remind you of anyone?
Remind you of anyone?
Yeah, in your pants.
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 In your pants. All right. I forgot what she was going to ask me now. This is from Kimberly in Midlothian in Texas. Says, hi, Craig, should I get a flu shot this year? I've never had the flu. Wow. It's, the flu shot is a bit like elephant repellent. You know what I mean? It's like, and people say, oh, I put down elephant repellent. You go, well, there's no elephants around here. And you go, know what I mean? I get a flu shot every year, though, and I got the, what was the big scare last year?
H1N1.
Yeah, but what was the name for it? Bird flu. No, that was bird man. Swine flu, that's right, yeah, swine flu. That's what happens in that movie. Owls chase all the pigs with swine flu away. And everybody learns about life. This is from Kaylee in Bowling Green, which is also in Ohio. She says, dear Craig, how can I make new friends at college without seeming too pushy or too... Hey, I didn't do anything. That was a simple slip of the tongue.
In your pants.
Hey! By the way, a simple slip of the tongue is the name of a movie which I've just had an idea for. It's a double feature with Bosom Serpent. Anyway, Kaylee in Bowling Green, Ohio says, dear Craig, how can I make new friends at college without seeming too pushy or clingy? Easy, easy, easy toga party. All right, then. This is from Jimmy in Lake Tahoe in Nevada. Yeah, it loses its comedic value after a while. I've been doing it for 5 years, 6 years, nearly 6 years doing that. You know, at a certain point, I know it's not funny anymore, but it's like a tick. You know, I just like, I have to do it. Do it? Yeah. All right, don't. Jimmy in Lake Tahoe in Nevada says, Craig. He says, Craig, do you think the Panthers will cover the spread against the Buccaneers on Sunday? I have no idea what you were talking about. I think you got the wrong show there, buddy. In your pants.
In your pants.
In your pants!
In your pants.
In your pants.
In your pants.
We'll be right back.
In your pants.
Tonight's edition of In Your Pants. Don't. My first guest tonight is a... I'm surprised that he didn't, actually. Don't. My first guest tonight is on the Project Runway. He's an author of Gunn's Golden Rules. It's on the number 5 on the New York Times bestseller list. Please welcome the genius that is Tim Gunn, everybody.
I have to say, Craig, you were number four on the New York Times bestseller list.
I was number four on the New York Times bestseller list, but not while your book was out. Well, I wouldn't have even been on, because
I always will be in your shadow, and it makes me very happy.
No, I don't think you will. I think it'll go up.
We'll see.
No, it will.
Listen, the fact that I'm on the list at all is so unbelievably thrilling. You should have heard me in the taxi today when I found out, when I landed at LAX.
What noise did you make?
I think that the poor taxi driver is now at a hearing clinic.
Really? I quite like to hear the noise you make. If you think you could recreate it for us.
It's probably something that Jeff would be capable of.
Well,
this worries me.
No, stop it.
You know what worries me?
What?
Talking about someone leaving poop on the carpet and hearing Jeff constantly say, in your pants. There's some weird association there. And it makes me decidedly uncomfortable.
No, I don't make any connection there at all. Jeff, you make any connection there? No, yeah, you're on your own there, Tim.
He's in denial. He's in denial.
He is a little bit, yeah. He has no idea he can't get further than 12 foot from an outlet. Tell me about your book, Tim. Tell me about the golden rules for making it work.
This book...
Is it all about fashion?
No.
Ooh.
In fact, there's very little about fashion in here.
Really?
I wrote it as though I were speaking to young people in my office, giving them advice about how to navigate the world with responsibility and respect for yourself and for your fellow human beings, which may sound a little highfalutin, but I wanted something that's an antidote to all this bad behavior that surrounds us. I mean, everywhere where you look, people are yelling profanities and slapping and hair pulling and...
This is about me, isn't it?
You're one of the good guys.
All of those things. It's true.
And you know, the fact that you're one of the good guys is why I'm so delighted that you and Megan are expecting.
Oh, yes. Yeah, no, expecting.
It's wonderful.
Yeah, which is good because she's pregnant.
Yeah. Yeah, you'll be great parents. There's a fair amount about parenting in here as
really?
Well.
Really?
Yeah.
What about parenting? You don't have any kids, do you?
Well, I taught for 29 years.
Right, okay.
So in a manner of speaking.
Yeah, well, you'll have a lot then. Ooh. Oh. Oh. Now I read that you got into a little bit of trouble because you were dishing a bit of dirt in the book, right?
Actually, I will correct that.
Oh, right, good.
I don't believe that I dish any dirt.
Right.
I report the facts.
Ah.
I don't editorialize.
Where I come from, mister, that's called being a rat.
Well, I will tell you, Gallery Books, which is a division of Simon & Schuster,
right.
Their legal department spent a couple of weeks with this book.
Yeah.
And they did their due diligence. Everything was checked out. If there was anything that was even remotely questionable, it was removed from the book.
Yeah, no, they're crazy about that.
I remember
when I wrote my book.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, did this really happen? I'm like, I'm not sure I was drunk. They're like, well, it has to go.
The one thing they asked me to do was to sit down with my family, with the galleys,
right.
And share them with them,
yeah.
Because there's a lot about my family in here. And I said, under no circumstances, I said, it is easier to ask forgiveness than permission.
Oh, good for
and
you.
It is.
Yeah. Is that one of the golden rules?
In a manner of speaking,
yeah.
It is. No, not actually.
Right,
no.
Okay.
But it is.
What's this very shiny looking
it's
object?
It's a golden apple.
Oh.
It's the apple of knowledge.
Oh, but the apple of knowledge was the knowledge of good and evil, which, you know, that's not...
Good and evil. No, it's a morality tale.
I don't know.
I'm that 19th century New England guy you were talking about earlier.
Nathaniel Hawthorne? It's Nathaniel Hawthorne with fashion. I love it. What about
that'll have your
what about Project Runway this season? I'm as deeply involved as ever I was.
Oh, I'm glad.
And I was very sad to see Casanova go. I thought he was a great addition to the.
Though I will tell you something.
What?
The show this week.
Yes.
I miss Casanova too, but I was so grateful not to have him because the challenge that's presented this week is so complicated that
yes.
If he were still on the show, it would have taken me a week to explain it to him.
Yeah, because his English wasn't very good, was it?
It was questionable.
Yeah, yeah. Because he used to just like, you know, they would say, the challenge this week is to, you know, make a hat out of, you know, metal, and he'd be like,
Hey, exactly. And he was like that during the entire work in the workroom on the challenge.
Yeah, but I tell you what I did notice this year, which I haven't noticed in previous Project Runways, is that you went after one of the contestants.
I've never done it before.
Yeah, I was quite amazed that Gretchen, who was behaving rather badly, and you said,
Well, and I'll add, Craig, I really went after the whole team.
You did, that's
true.
They're but you
all six designers. Well, because she was at the core of the issue.
Yes.
And there was no team leader, yet she's bullying, she's manipulating. Mm. And when I saw this happening, because it really didn't fully reveal itself until the designers were on the runway before the judges, I have no part in that. I'm just an observer.
Right.
So I wanted to address it with the designers and say, you know something? Big Daddy saw all that stuff, and Big Daddy's not very happy about it.
Do you call yourself Big Daddy?
I would with my students. I do occasionally with them. I should say granddad, given how young everyone is.
No, Big Daddy is fine. But now, Gretchen, it should be said, though, is not without talent.
She's extremely talented.
Yes, absolutely.
And very, very smart, very articulate.
Yes.
Bitch.
She's not. I think she's nervous, and it comes across
like
that.
Well, she, like every good designer I know, she is a complete and total unbridled control freak.
Well, artists are like, any artist is like that. You know, they get, you can't, it doesn't always come in a neat package. I think, you know, people think, oh, what a great guy he is. They go, yes, but he's completely boring. You know, there are some people who are difficult and complicated, and that's what I quite like about Project Runway.
I do too.
They're complicated and difficult and unlikable, some of them.
I do have a little issue to take with you about the cover of the book. I hope you don't mind, but you're wearing a bow tie here. I don't know if you...
But not on the back. The back is the antidote.
No.
But on the cover, it's the bow tie.
Yeah, you can't say... That's like saying, I took a dump in your carpet, but don't worry, I'm going to clear it up. It would be best had you not done it in the first place.
You know, I have to tell you, I have a thing about bow ties. Too.
Really?
I do. And I used to wear them all the time. And I probably had 40 of them. And then I had a boss at Parsons School of Design who wore bow ties all the time. And he was an ass. Mm. And I thought...
That's just reporting the facts.
I thought, I can't do this anymore. So I gave them all to my brother-in-law.
And he lent you one back for the...
No, this is actually my tuxedo bow tie. It's black silk.
So it's a black silk bow tie with a plaid shirt and
a vest.
And a vest.
But we thought it looked more professorial.
Make it work, because...
But you're not...
Frankly, I'm concerned.
You're not the first person to point this out issue with it.
It's very on you. I don't see it. Which I think is probably a good idea for the cover of the book.
If you ever have me back, I'll wear a bow tie.
Oh, no, I'll have you back any old time. You don't have to wear anything you like.
You could say, I'll never have you back again, Tim, because of this bow tie.
No, I wouldn't do that. I might actually have to do that.
See?
No, it's not. It's just that, wait a minute, that's the same shirt.
It was the same photo shoot.
Yeah, but you got to change the shirt, haven't man?
It was about options.
Oh, I see. Yes. No, you're right.
And then the art director, we did everything with the two looks, and the art director decided what was going on the cover.
Now, was the bookcase really there, or did you put it in later?
You know, this is very interesting. It's a place in New York on Lexington Avenue called Bar and Books, and it's a bar. These books are all fake. They're just spines.
Oh. It's like Hollywood.
Well, it was a set.
Except less spines here. Yeah. Well, listen, good luck with it, although you hardly need it, given that you're number four already. That's fantastic.
Five.
Number five, five, five.
I'd like to be number four.
I don't know
where
the number four came from.
He does know.
No, but that's good. You four and then on to the top three, and then you'll, then that'll work out.
Well, truly, I'm so thrilled to be on the list. It's surreal.
Fantastic. It's a big success. Good for you. Well done. It's always lovely to see you. And I really am enjoying Project Runway. A real return to form this season.
Well,
thank you.
Just wait.
Oh, really?
Is all I have to say.
Don't. Yeah.
Just wait.
All right. Well, what now? I can just wait right now. Do you want to? Let's do that. We'll just wait, and I'll play the harmonica. You ready?
I'd love it.
All right. Just wait. I'm just waiting. We're just waiting.
Well, it's the commercials. But Tim Gunn, everybody, come on.
Thank you.
The Friday night edition of In Your Pants. My next guest. My next guest is on a new show which premieres Wednesday on ABC. It's called. It's called Better With You, CBS. No, the show is called Better With You. Take a look at this.
Don't think this is too fast?
Well, not everyone is going to wait 15 years.
Oh, darling, stop. Is that directed at me?
No, it's directed at Kurt Russell and Goldie Hawn.
Okay, guys, this is my moment. I just got engaged. Make fun of Maddie when she gets engaged. In 2044. Oh. Hey, or not being married is a valid life
choice. Okay, she said it. Everybody has to drink.
It looks funny, actually, doesn't it? Yeah. Huh. We've got a guest called Jennifer Finnigan. Come on, then. Stu, you haven't been here in ages. Look at you, look lovely.
No,
and,
thank
oh, let's
you.
Sing the song. You can
okay,
sing
okay.
The, all right, we've got a guest called Jennifer Finnigan.
She has whiskers on her chin again. She got fat and then got thin again. Did you not make a new verse?
No. I did. I just made it up. She also has got lovely hair, and she knows how to skin a bear. And by the phrase skin a bear, I mean something naughty. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, no, it's all right, actually. You want to try and get me in the writer's room for that? I'm sure you're doing. How is it working over at ABC?
It is good.
It's all right.
Yeah,
it sure looks funny.
It's really fun.
Yeah.
And the cast is so good, and it just feels like we've all known each other forever.
Have you?
Well, I the girl who plays my sister, Joanna, I've known for years.
Did you know her in college? Maybe share a dorm, pillow fights?
No, but she was the first person that I practiced kissing on.
Oh, okay. Yeah. That's good. Yeah. Hang on.
Right here.
More for that, where that came from. Not a lot more, but some.
Did you? What are those for?
These are in case I have difficult guests.
Oh.
So, like, if they go, what was it like working with George Clooney? And they go, I don't know. And I go, does this refresh your memory?
Oh, nice. Point system.
Yeah.
Like every time you say something funny, you get a dollar.
So, did you really do that thing with a hamster? I don't know what you're talking about. Really? How about now?
Like
well, Mr. Tweety came into the room and. Oh, the hamsters
like
don't tweet, or do they?
I don't know, but you tweet, don't you? You're on Twitter.
I do, I'm on the Twitter. Yeah, you on the Tweety?
I'm on the Twitter.
Really?
Yeah.
What's your Twitter handle?
It's at Jennigan. I thought it was a good mix of Jennifer and Finnigan. And I can't fit Jennifer Finnigan, it was Jennifer Finnega. Every time I try to.
I like that though.
Do you like that?
Jennifer Finnegan.
Go.
Yeah.
Or.
It sounds classy.
Could have gone
Jennifer
really.
Finnegan.
Oh.
Yeah.
So I went with Jennigan.
Yeah.
But didn't. We're really good friends with Saget, with Bob Saget.
Bob Saget?
Didn't he get you on.
Yeah, I think Bob kind of got me into it a little bit. I had lunch with him and he said, let's do a photograph and Twitter our photograph. And I was like,
he
no.
He told us that.
No, man. But we did anyway.
And now you have like 4 million followers.
No, not at all. I've about 12.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
I have 400.
You get 400? 400's good,
no,
though.
No,
I don't know. See, it's when everything turns into a competition, it makes me crazy.
I know.
No, I like doing it, but then when people say, you don't have as much followers.
Right, and
as,
it's like you're not the most popular girl in school. I
right,
know.
Right, yeah. Right. Yeah. I had that problem.
Right?
Yeah,
like,
yes. Right, so what's the show about then?
Okay, so. This is weird.
What, my bosom's there?
It's been so long. It's been so long that the last time I was here, you didn't have that ridiculous cup, and you didn't have a sidekick either.
Yeah, that we call them the good old days. Right?
You mean that in a good way, right, Craig?
Yeah, why not? Yeah, in your pants.
In your mom's pants.
In your pants.
Yeah, I know, it's awful. Have you got a robot around the house or any other appliance?
Like one of those robot vacuum cleaners?
You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
No, I don't. Love
it. Give me another dollar.
There you go.
Cracking it up.
No, the last time I saw you was in Montreal, wasn't it?
The last time you saw me, I was a girl, and now I'm a woman.
Yeah, that's right. It was before you were married.
Yeah, it was in Montreal. It was at the Just for Laughs Comedy Fest.
Right, that's right. Yeah.
You know where I went since then? To your homeland.
Scotland?
I did.
No way. What did you do?
My hubby was doing a movie in London, and we just hopped over there.
Oh, really? Did you have a nice time?
We went to Edinburgh.
Oh, yeah.
Did I say it right?
Yeah, they were going to have their own Twitter thing, but then it came out Edinburgh.
I couldn't bother.
It's a very beautiful town, Edinburgh, though, isn't it?
It was amazing. we did the ghost tour.
The ghost tour?
Yeah, have you done that?
Oh, here, no.
They take you down underneath the city?
No.
Why, did you have a bad experience?
That was my childhood, the ghost tour.
Did you live down there?
I lived in the dungeons of Edinburgh, yeah.
Well, that explains it.
Occasionally, we would see something float by.
Oh, no. Oh, yes. This went dark. I was just going to tell you about my lovely trip.
Well,
all of a sudden, we're talking about floating bodies.
But no, I wasn't a body. They weren't floating bodies. No, they were floaters.
In your pants.
Okay. Yeah.
All right, shut up, Jeff.
Although you were asking for it there.
Yeah, kind of, I suppose so. Yeah, so you went to Scotland. Well, that's nice. You had a nice time. Were the people nice to you? Did you get any sleep?
It was so lovely. Oh, God, I got so drunk.
I know.
Because it's just like, it's water to them, the beer.
Yeah, well, the beer and then there's other stuff. I think it's whiskey called.
Vaguely remember.
So you were there and now you're back.
I know, I'm back.
And are you in, you're not in Montreal, are you?
No, honey, I'm here. So the show.
The show.
I feel like I need to get back.
All right, yeah, what's the show?
Just for one second.
Friends become enemies,
Wednesdays at 8:30. It's about three couples, like a young, hot couple, and then like the couple that's been together for 10 years and are not married, that's played by myself and an actor named Josh Cook, who I worked with 6 years ago, ironically, on a different show.
Shut up.
I know. And then the parents, who are awesome, Deborah Jo Rupp and Kurt Fuller.
Right.
And they're the ones that have been together for like 30 years
and how do all these people tolerate each other?
No. We're all family.
Oh, I see. It's not some kind of sex cult.
No.
You never know with ABC.
It might be like sex cult.
Tonight on ABC.
Yeah, see, that would make it so much more interesting.
No.
You should pitch that.
What, sex cult?
Yeah.
I pitched it on CBS,
but they
wanted everyone to be over 80. Hey! Everybody put your walker in the center of the room.
No.
Yeah.
Put your IV drip in the bowl.
No.
Like a key party.
Yeah.
See where I went with that.
Did you ever do a key party?
No, I've never done one, but they intrigue me. Not from a point of view like I would want to participate.
You just want to watch?
Oh, yeah.
I got a couple of websites you might be interested in. We're out of time, you know.
We are?
Yeah, I know, it's ridiculous, but look at the money you made.
I know how much. I've got like 10 bucks here.
Yeah, easily.
I can buy myself a deep fried beer with that.
Oh, mama, that's right. Yeah. Go ahead. Then we're bringing everybody over right back.
What did we learn on the show tonight, Greg?
Don't worry, the large cat was replaced by a smaller cat wearing a parachute. In your pants.
In your pants.
Good, everybody!